The clash between Tony Greville and Geraldo de Freitas is also taking place next weekend. We'll first put on a brief analysis on Tony Greville. 70 inches is his reach, fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida. Bantamweight fighter, he fought at CES previously, where he was very dominant against Cody Norby, Chris Moutinho, Darren Mima. He won contract against Ray Rodriguez at Dana White Contender Series, but he lost to via rear naked choke to Brad Jones. Very, very powerful when it comes to striking, very great stamina. His weak spot might be submission defense, which I could have seen in some of his fights. And also he lost his first match to Pat Sabatini, and majority of his losses actually came via rear naked choke or armbar against Manny Bermudez, Patchy Mix. He was losing to big names, I mean Tony Greville, but overall a very, very good well-rounded mixed martial artist. Now he meets Geraldo de Freitas, Brazilian mixed martial artist known under the nickname the Espartano. Geraldo de Freitas riding on a score of 12-5, his reach is 72.5 and he is 5'7" fighter, which means he's gonna have a reach advantage fighting out of Minas Gerais, Brazil. Geraldo de Freitas was very dominant at Shota Brazil. He kicked off in jungle fight with a lot of losses at Bitetti Combat, but he had losses ups and downs. But he showed very, very much great submission skills, you know. Armbar, rear naked choke specialist. He also, whenever he was going to decision, he was fighting very, very well. At UFC and ESPN Plus 2, he defeated Felipe Colares via decision, but then he lost to Chris Gutierrez. It was a very close split decision. Very good ground fighter, maybe not the most entertaining fighter to watch, not gonna lie. His striking might not be the best in the world, but he's very, very good on the ground. And he likes to go to judges' scorecards, fight very much technically, tactically, and very, very good name for me. And now comparative analysis. Well, Geraldo de Freitas is going to have reach advantage, but I think Tony Greville is a faster fighter. Who can bet that Geraldo de Freitas' score, if the fight is taken to the ground, is gonna be very, very hard night to Tony Greville. Tony Greville knows to slam people, to TKO, to punch them out, but this is kinda clash of two different martial arts on the ground, and American top team fighter is strong, but he'll have to keep this fight standing if he wants to win. And Tony Greville on the other side, he fought wisely against Brad Jones, but he made one error, which cost him a lot, so he'll have to keep this fight standing. Geraldo de Freitas is so, so good on the ground, and whenever Tony Greville was fighting to decision, he was mostly winning. I mean, he has a lot of decision wins under his belt. He has 8 decision wins. On the other side, Geraldo de Freitas also has few decision wins and some decision losses, which I believe Tony Greville has better striking and better, maybe slightly better clinching and better ground game when it comes to punching, but Geraldo de Freitas has nasty submissions, and I believe Tony Greville is a better striker, so it purely depends on which way the fight is going to go. If the fight remains standing, it's gonna be a victory for Tony Greville, but if the fight is taken to the ground, I'm gonna give advantage to Geraldo Freitas. If I really have to pick one guy, I would give very slight advantage to Geraldo de Freitas, but my prediction is this fight goes the distance. I don't see stoppages in this fight, so I say this fight goes the distance. So I think it will last for 3 rounds.